blue sky. Please tell us why.
Good morning, Fairmont. Welcome back to the Newsroom. My name's Nicole.
And my name's Devin. Now here's Emma with events.
Boys Basketball City Tournament is next week, Wednesday through Friday. No school Monday. Happy President's Day.
Hey there, Fairmont. If you don't already know, or if you haven't heard over the morning announcements, we have an audition for the talent show coming up next week. We're actually starting the auditions for the talent show next Wednesday on the 20th. The talent show is actually the day before spring break on the 15th of March, but you need to have an audition before you can be in the talent show. And so we have the applications available at the main office. You can pick them up there. They need to be turned in to me by the end of the day next Tuesday on the 19th. So please, 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 if you want to audition for us and be seen on the talent show, get those applications in to me, Mr. Kloppenberg, no later than the end of the day next Tuesday. Thanks.
Bonjour tout le monde. La semaine prochaine, les cours de français vont vendre les crêpes. Et ce sont tellement délicieux. Alors, venir le mardi, mercredi et jeudi, et nous allons, vous pouvez acheter les crêpes. Les crêpes seront $1 chaque. Et puis, si vous voulez mettre plus de choses sur ton crêpe, ça ne va coûter que 50 centimes de plus. Alors, venir acheter un crêpe et manger bien.
Well, one challenge that I experienced was I didn't really grow up in a family that valued education. And for whatever reason, I wanted to go to college, and I can't really explain why. I had parents that really didn't care if I even graduated from high school. So, needless to say, I didn't really come prepared graduating from high school to do rigorous coursework or, you know, what that meant. I didn't even know what I wanted to do for a career because that was never asked of me. So it was a very bumpy road. I went to two community colleges and then I went to Boise State, and I didn't really understand guidance. I didn't understand coursework or what you needed to graduate. And I had to make up a lot of math because I didn't get very far in high school because I didn't understand the importance of taking things seriously. But I never gave up, even though I didn't really have family support. And I started with a business degree. So I have a marketing and finance degree. I figured that everything is a business, even a church and a school. So I figured I could probably get a job doing that. And then eventually, over time, I realized what I really liked to do was working with kids. And so that was the direction someone had suggested that I go to school to get my counseling degree, because I was working in a school. So I just kept pushing myself and kept telling myself I could do it. I think one of the hardest things when I was at Boise State was you had to do everything by paper then. They didn't have computers to tell you you need to take this class first or this class. And so I had this counselor person call me in one day. I didn't even know they had counselors at Boise State. And she said, "You're on probation." And I said, "For what?" And she said, "Well, you didn't take this class before this class, and if you don't pass this class, then you can't continue on." And she said, "Apparently you need this class because it's legal environment of business and you don't know how to read things." And it was so devastating because I just thought, I am trying so hard to do this on my own, and I didn't even realize you could reach out to people to ask, how do I graduate from college? So I really worked hard to make sure I passed that class. But it was, I felt like, you know, it was just a lot of barriers and hurdles, but I never gave up. And so I'm very thankful that I didn't, because I wouldn't be here now. So that was one of my biggest challenges.
Thanks, Emma. Now here's Aaliyah with LGBTQ Club.
What is the LGBTQ Club?
The LGBTQ Club is an organization here at Fairmont that allows those students that identify as lesbian, gay, transgender, bisexual, queer, or even their allies, a place to come once a week. We meet on Thursdays during both lunch periods, and it gives them a chance to come and talk to other students that are going through the same issues they are going through, to talk about the things they experience here at school, to give them just a place where they can feel safe to express themselves and the issues that, again, that they face, not only here at Fairmont, but in the wider society as well.
What is your favorite thing about the LGBTQ Club?
I like how we can all be like included in like one group in one subject without feeling outside and alone.
It's a really accepting environment, which is really good, especially because in a lot of places, people like us don't feel super accepted. So it's just good to have a place where we can just talk freely about whatever we want to, feel freely however we want to, and that's just really cool. It makes Fairmont a whole lot more inviting.
When and where does the club meet?
We meet on Thursdays during fifth period lunch. They meet in Mr. Hiller's room, which I believe is room 35. And then on Thursdays, they meet in Miss Hill's room, which is room 23. And again, they usually meet during both lunch periods every Thursday.
Thanks, Leah. Now here's Emma with cleaning up.
Thanks, Emma. Now here's Aaliyah with Lip Sync Battle.
Welcome back to the Lip Sync Battle. This week we have Mr. McDermott versus Mr. Dean. They will be performing Your Heart Will Go On by Celine Dion. Now here's Mr. McDermott. Thank you, Mr. McDermott. Now here's Mr. Dean. Thank you, Mr. Dean. Don't forget to vote at the end of the video.
Thanks, Lily, and thanks to all the teachers that participated.
That's all the time we have for today. Thanks for tuning into the Newsroom.